are your ExactCast headlines for your Sunday morning. Partly cloudy, hot and humid. We are going to work in maybe a few isolated showers and storms throughout the viewing area, mainly where you get a little interaction between the water and the land, say near the lake and maybe down the coast near the Gulf of Mexico. All right, so let's have a look at the satellite imagery. We've been talking about Tropical Storm Alex because we are keeping an eye on him. Here he is currently moving across the Yucatan Peninsula. Kind of held himself together pretty well, doesn't he? He's got that nice counterclockwise rotation. He's going to be reemerge back into the southern Gulf of Mexico. Let me show you the forecast model, because here's how it's shaking out right now. According to the National Hurricane Center, Alex is going to move across the Yucatan Peninsula. He'll probably weaken, maybe be downgraded to a tropical depression. That won't last long. As he continues moving toward the northwest, he's going to move into some really warm water, which is going to help him re-intensify. The shear environment here is very low, so there's nothing really to inhibit further development except for interaction with the land. So this is what the models are showing, that it is going to move toward the west, say late Wednesday night, early Thursday morning, and possibly become a Category 2 hurricane. The only problem for us is there are still two models. These are two different models from the ones we spoke of yesterday. Yesterday it was the GFDL and the HWRF. Now it's the GFS and the Canadian. They are bringing the storm to the north, mainly near Texas and the Louisiana coastline. Most of the models, the majority of the models, do bring it on this path. What I'm saying is, a take-home message is you got to keep an eye on it just to make sure it doesn't move this way, because if it does, the water here is pretty warm and it could cause us a few issues, not to say the least. Right now, max sustained winds are 40 miles per hour. Outside right now, 74 in Slidell, 78 in Gulfport, 83 at the Lakefront Airport. So here's how things are going to shake out today. Forecast model showing some isolated coverage. We'll call it isolated, about a 20% chance of showers and storms. This is about 40%. Doesn't look like it, does it? I think this frontal boundary here is going to be sagging a little bit further to the south, and we'll get a little bit more moisture being pumped in with a decent southeasterly flow, and we'll continue that working on Tuesday. So rain chances will definitely increase as we start your work week tomorrow. In the meantime, high tides and low tides for the Wrigley's Grand Isle and the Southwest Pass, your range just under 2 feet. Day parts forecast are showing temperatures region-wide are going to be in the lower to mid-90s, and your seven-day ExactCast, there's a little 20% chance of rain. Still hot and humid. We'll have sunshine in the afternoon, and then we are going to get maybe some of those clouds developing. And as you can see, about a 40% chance of showers through Thursday. There's your look at weather. Let's